parents thought their son was just playing on a computer. And after 2 years, he hired them. Hey friends, while many of us simultaneously have several jobs just to feed our family, or are forced to work under different conditions for 12 hours a day and get in debt, there's a very different category of people who just look you in the eye with a smile and say, "Do you want to have a beautiful big house, cool car, travel around the world and relax in expensive resorts?" If the answer is yes, then you just need an old laptop and a neighbor's Wi-Fi. And it works, because these are the people we hear every time, very successful people, are asked how to create their own business. And all this is true because in the era of the internet, absolutely anyone, even a child from the smallest village, can create a product that will not only make him worldwide famous, but also increase his fortune by hundreds of millions. Don't believe it? Then you should definitely hear this story. A boy named Jordan Casey was born in Ireland in the year 2000 to a regular family. His parents were simple workers who could not even dream of having a big house of their own, let alone a huge amount of money. Sometimes, as they say, they had to work to make ends meet, and they earned money was hardly enough for a normal life. As a consequence, the boy's childhood did not differ from his peers, playing on the streets, watching favorite cartoon series, and of course, video games. That's how he spent most of his time, sitting in front of an old computer that barely could do basic tasks. Many people ask what's surprising about it, because at the time all the children were doing something similar. And that's true indeed. And perhaps we would never have heard the name of this boy if at the age of 9 he hadn't started to be interested in computers. One day, after school, sitting at home at his computer, he thought that creating his own blog could be a very interesting hobby. And Casey didn't just think about it and forget how most of us usually do it. He started working on a new idea the same day. Obviously, the guy had little knowledge in any areas and topics, so he began to write about what he knew, namely about the games he played. But the more Casey shared information about what he saw on his computer monitor, the more unfamiliar things started to appear on his blog. By that time, classmates and just friends began to ask him a lot of questions, to which he didn't know the answer. And actually, he decided to expand his knowledge on different topics in order to not be made fun of. One day, I decided to study it all better and started reading relevant literature. I found different articles on websites, which, by the way, were very boring and I didn't understand at least half of what was written. At the same time, I set myself one task, namely to understand all this better than my classmates. So I asked my parents to buy me a book on programming, and my father refused. My parents were generally against me sitting at my computer for 24/7. Often, they even forbade me to turn it on. Besides, there were also school lessons and a lot of things that I had to do around the house. I offered my father and mother one option, which is that I will deal with my lessons and other tasks, and as an encouragement, they'll allow me to use the computer. Looking ahead, I will say that each of the parents kept their promise. When Jordan was 9.5 years old, that's when his father gave him a book on programming. It was since then that the era of Jordan Casey began. Having studied the book from cover to the last page, the guy decided to try to create his own application. However, there were still 3 years left before the application was released. From the age of 10 to 12, Jordan learned how to create websites by sitting at home on his computer and at the same time focusing on creating his application. Often, at such a young age, his parents and sometimes neighbors resorted to his services. He also helped his classmates in every way and all those who toured with him. But no one could imagine that Jordan was working on a huge project. My parents thought I was just playing video games. They didn't even realize then that I was actually making them. Thanks to a huge effort, at the age of 13, Jordan finally made his first creation. His first Alien Ball vs. Humans project was similar in concept to Space Invaders, Jordan's favorite game. The first few weeks after the release, the developer gave them away for free to create hype. Of course, the guy had a hard time getting into the App Store. According to him, Apple was picking on the slightest errors and not allowing to publish the game until they're corrected. But it motivated him even more to improve his product. A few months later, he updated them, and both games began to sell in the App Store for 99 cents. It's hard to believe, but in 2012, he led the App Store charts in his native country of Ireland with a game called Alien Ball. Initially, it was just an experimental game to test iPhone technologies. I didn't even expect it to work so well. Of course, it helped to raise the popularity, as well as the fact that the game was made by such a young man. During the review of Apple, Casey wrote in the description that the game is designed for those who are older than 12 years. This is what attracted the attention of the company. Soon, Apple contacted him and subsequently placed the game on its website. Since then, he's made several apps, including the sequel to Alien Ball. Given Casey's age, as might be expected, he aroused a lot of interest in his persona. Already in 2013, he was invited as Young Breakthrough to the Festival of Cannes, where he even gave a speech. In addition, the organizers of the Children's Day from Brazil approached him and asked him to make a game for them, to which he responded by agreeing. The game he created was played more than 15,000 times in one day. In the same 2013, Jordan decided to become an entrepreneur and opened his company called Casey's Games. Because of his age, the company was registered to Casey's parents. At the same time, he hired his first employee. It was Aiden Brickett, his classmate, who took the position of art director. It should be noted that at this time, the boy was still in school. We can't say that Jordan's further games were popular. According to application statistics, his new creations did not receive much feedback, but despite this, the young developer improved his skills and understood that he was only at the beginning of his journey. In 2014, Casey decided on more sophisticated software by launching TeachVR, an application that allows teachers to manage information about students. The idea came to my mind when my teacher lost her big black book with all the details of attendance and the results of students' tests. I thought it was just weird that it was 2014 then, and teachers still had a book with grades. This is how TeachVR appeared, an application that's encrypted and stored in the cloud, so there's no possibility to lose information. It's worth noting that a year later, it was actively used by over 300 schools in Ireland. Now it's widely used in some countries of Asia, Africa, and Europe. Jordan even received an award for it at the Exhibition for Young Scientists in 2015. When journalists interviewed him in the same 2015, they noted that Jordan Casey, despite his age, is modest, but at the same time very confident in himself. He said this was not always the case. Previously, I was shy and not used to all this attention. When I was only 13 years old, I was invited to the world festivals and conferences. I was treated as if I were a celebrity, put in limousines, and checked into the most expensive hotels. And I was still that boy with the old computer on his desk. In January, I was making my own game, and 4 months later, I sent it to tell the world about my story. Casey's parents still live in Waterford Island, though in a new house, which our guy bought them. Father and mother now work in a son's company, holding important key positions. The self-taught programmer is now the CEO and founder of such companies as Independent Game Studios, Casey's Games, Save the Day, and Food World. I think it would be no surprise to anyone that after receiving his first million, a teenager from Ireland began traveling and opening more and more startups. Today, he's a frequent guest at the headquarters of such companies as Apple and Google. He speaks at prestigious conferences and often meets with Jack Dorsey, co-founder of Twitter. He's a speaker at Silicon Valley, one of the world's largest business conferences, where he met Jeff Leiner, CEO of LinkedIn. In general, this is the story of an ordinary Irish guy who just decided once, sitting at home, that he needs to learn something new. And this new thing changed forever not only his life, but also the lives of others. Everything depends on us, and each person controls his own happiness. Do you guys agree with these words? Be sure to write your opinion in the comments. And that's all for today. Please like this video if you enjoyed it, and see you soon.